Good morning, everyone. Welcome to CDIT Infotech Private Limited. Myself is Vinod. Today, we are going to learn how to create a database and a table in MS SQL Server 2012. First of all, start MS SQL Server 2012. SQL Server Management Studio. This is server name, leave as it is. Login ID is SA, SS stand for system administrator, and the password which we had set at the time installation of SQL Server. Click on connect. Now your system, your own system, will be treated as server. Right click on database, click on new database, assign a name like shop db. You can assign any name. Click on OK button. Now your database got created. Just check it. Click on the plus sign before the database option. You can see here your database got created. Now we have to create a table, so extend this option, right click on table, choose the first option, that is new table. Now write the column name like item code. Be careful, you don't have to have any space in the field name. You cannot start the field name with digit, and also you cannot have any symbol in the field name. Now choose the data type. Right now we are choosing varchar, means we can have the letter as well as digit, as well as we can have the symbol in the item code. Write the second field name, item name. Again, assign the data type as varchar. And the third field name is rate. It will be used to store the rate. Choose the data type as numeric, because it will store your number. And here you can see 18,0 means you can have the total number of digits as 18 and no digits after decimal. If you want to have two digits after symbol decimal, use here 2. Now you can have 15 digits before the dot and 2 digits after dot, after decimal. Next field name is quantity. Again assign as numeric, leave it as it is. And one more field name, amount. Again choose the numeric type. Now it should make the item code as primary key. To make it primary key, just right click at the left of the item code and choose the first one, set primary key. What is the advantage of setting the field name as the primary key? It means it will stop duplicacy. Means it cannot assign same item code to two items. Now save the table. Right click here, choose the option save table. Assign a name. I'm assigning here items, because we are going to store many items. Click on OK. So this is the way through which we can create the database as well as table. Now you can extend this plus symbol. See, you have created the item table. If you want to see the column name of the items table, you can again click here and click on columns. You can double click on columns to extend it. You can see the name of the fields as well as data type and which field is primary key, item code is primary key. You can see here PK stands for primary key. There are five columns and the data types are given. So you can create the database and table in this way. Thank you. Please subscribe this channel, like this video and click on bell icon to get our latest video. In the next chapter, we will learn to create database and table using SQL Server by writing SQL query. Thank you for watching this video. Please share us about this video by writing your comment. Thank you.